a group of 12 students that spent 10 days in South Dakota on an Indian reservation. For many, it was the first airplane ride and a long ride by motor vehicle after that. And they were able to see what the countryside looked like in South Dakota.
On June 28, 12 students began a journey that would indeed change their lives. Thursday morning, students began to arrive at Reagan National Airport for what they found that led to it be an experience like no other.
First of all, I've never been on an airplane before. Oh my goodness, we had to take two planes to get there, and it was a long road trip. When we first got there, I never been horseback riding. I went horseback riding. I never been fishing, canoeing. I never ate buffalo. We had buffalo burgers. We also did this thing called, I forget what was the name of it, the Sweat Lodge. It was like a little praying ritual they did. And they put steaming hot red rocks in a pit in the middle of the cave, and they would throw water on it, and you would just sweat bullets. But when you come out, it's so refreshing. Oh, I went to sleep. That was the best nap I've had in my life after that.
What I really enjoyed was going to the Sweat Lodge. I thought that was a beautiful experience, because after we came from out of there, everybody shook hands, gave each other a hug. It was just like a family reunion, even though it was white people there, Indians and black people. It was just a family reunion. Everybody, it was no color on nobody's skin.
Going ahead, well, we had just finished painting the church, and before we finished, we could see like real dark clouds coming. We thought it was just going to be a real bad thunderstorm.
A little bit of rain coming on this year.
Woo-hoo! Get in the back of us.
As soon as we got in the van, we could hear the hail coming down. And some people was running through the hail, getting like hit and stuff. And the hail was like that big.
My first involvement in a tornado.
We saw the storm coming up, and the winds were kicking, and you could see it sweeping across the grass. And then it comes up and it surprises you. And the teepees were staked down pretty well, and one of them got knocked over. And it was an intense feeling. It was an intense rush. I think for the students, it was a first, and that they'd never experienced anything like that.
Those students went out to experience the lifestyle of the Native Americans on the reservation.
And taking them to a place where harmony and peace and love are naturally integrated in everything, from prayer to meals to activities, was a good way for the kids to learn about themselves and appreciate a new culture, and perhaps incorporate parts of that culture into how they viewed themselves and how they viewed their community, particularly their school community. The goal is for them to be able to come back and catalyze the school and help bring back with them a certain love and respect of nature, of the Lakota Sioux, of themselves, of the group, and take that and spread that and be ambassadors of that love that they learned. And that, I think a lot of the kids have that now.
One thing that I'll never forget in South Dakota is the word waka, which means God or higher being. And that's one thing that Jerry expressed to us, was a higher being. And that was one of the things that Native Americans believe in, was a higher being. And the whole life was revolved around that. And like Ed said, they didn't pray a lot. So that was one word that I didn't get.
My favorite experience is when me, Mr. White, Mark, and Jerry Farley went canoeing on the Cheyenne River. That was so beautiful because the sun was like, it was so close. It's like he just reached up and touched it.
It's real, real spiritual, real spiritual, man. I think a lot of students gathered themselves out there, and we became like a family out there. It was more of a family atmosphere, because all we had was each other.
As well as to contribute by using their construction skills to do work in buildings there to help improve the buildings.
I never took Mr. White electrical wiring class, but I went with him to the church. And I put up a light switch, and that was my first time ever doing that. So I thought that was nice, and I did it all by myself.
Everybody was just real nice, and Well, basically, we went out there to help them rebuild a lot of things. So basically, we went out there, you know, we had our fun. But we got the job done, and we got thanked for it at a powwow. And that really made me feel good, because it made me feel as though the work that we put into rebuilding the church and rebuilding the scaffold didn't go to waste, you know. So I feel as though that we helped them out, and that gave us the appreciation for doing the job.
I think that they learned a lot about themselves, how to get along together, how to get along with other people, how to listen, how to carry out a plan of attack. And overall, they talk about it every time you would mention it, that they talk about it with a great fervor, that they were enthused and would more than likely, if they gave a chance to go back again, each and every one of them would go back.
I didn't want to leave at first. When it was time to leave, I didn't want to leave. But while we were there, it was kind of like I wanted to go home. I was getting homesick and everything. But the only thing that really made me want to stay was, I mean, being with my friends and everything, and horseback riding. That was like the best thing of this trip.
I learned how to deal with my inner self. You know what I'm saying? Being in a peaceful environment without, you know what I'm saying, a lot of people for one, a lot of noise for another. You know what I'm saying? Just to cope with myself and with others.
In hindsight, the trip is magnificent. During the trip at times, it seemed impossible. But Jerry Farley is really the person who deserves the most credit for making this happen. His vision and his openness. I knocked on his door, having met him once and not calling ahead. And he welcomed me into his house, and I told him my idea, and he ran with it. And he set up amazing things on his end. And it's an amazing person that would give so much to strangers that he's never met. And he deserves all the respect that he's given on the reservation and all the respect that the kids have for him. He's truly an inspiration.
Lakota Souix, we love you.
It's just the experiences that I've been told, and the journals that I've read meant that, once again, we had a life-changing experience there.